Hello.
And welcome to my reaction to episode 1 of season 2 of Mushishi Zoku Shou. Basically. What else can I say? Final stretch. After this season of 10 episodes, there is still another 50 minute or 45 minute special, and then that's it. And I'm pretty sure that I've read that the final 45 minute special adapt the last arc of the manga, so it's basically a complete adaptation, which is always a good thing. It means I don't really have to worry about reading the manga right away, you know. Anyway, not much to say. It's Mushishi. It's always great. Episode 1. Let's get into this in 3, 2, 1. Is the opening different? Shiva by Lucy Rose. It's the same girl at least. Okay, it's the same song. It's 7 in the morning. That's why my brain is not working too much right now. Starting with the Mushishi that we don't know. Doesn't look good. Not at all. Oh, shit. Is it a flashback? Are we getting a Ginkgo story after Cushion of Grass, after he lost his memory? No, we know that after he lost his memory, he was taken in by that traveling troupe of people, and afterward he was given to a Mushishi. That's what we know. Kanpai. Okay. That's interesting. Obviously, you're not like them. Yeah. Okay, so that's not it. Just that. As it's really about to say, why is it that it attracts Mushi? Is there a special reason? But okay. Just because. And we know that as an adult, he still doesn't remember. That's why he smokes all the time, all right. I'm still surprised though about the gun. Before that one episode, where we saw the gun for the first time, it just felt like this wasn't that point yet in the story. you know, all of the Mountain Lord thing reminded me of Princess Mononoke a bit. And of course he goes. Oh. Is it the birth of the next Mountain Lord? Don't think you should touch it. Way. I mean, you are the chosen one in a way too. I don't know if that's how it works. Fucking, of course. Of course. Well, as I've said before, I guess this show is not about Ginkgo always solving the issue. Sometimes you even fuck it up pretty bad. Especially as a child like that, I guess it makes sense. If he's alive, there's no point. burst of light. Okay, I was thinking about it, but my Princess Mononoke comparison wasn't for nothing. This looked very much like the Mountain Lord from Princess Mononoke. Yeah. Maybe because it's a Tokoyami, Eternal Darkness, and it's in first in it's in it's looking at this path of light, which is absolute light. Maybe that's why. Kind of creepy. What was that final gesture for? Okay. I'm not very clever, it seems. That's what it meant. So it didn't actually fall into anything. Yeah, it was quite the moment. fan of. That was a pretty dumb mistake. And now, I guess, he doesn't really want to die anymore. Yeah. Alright. Interesting. Interesting. I do wonder if we're getting more flashback, because this scene doesn't answer too much. What I'm still wondering is how it came to have all this knowledge on Mushi. Because right now, he has maybe a little, but the fact that he's never really stayed long time with a single Mushishi definitely says that, yeah. The question is, did he learn everything on his own? Just by experience? I guess also of interest is Fekai. Yeah. Well, that wasn't bad. Maybe not one of my favorite episodes, but a flashback for the original Ginkgo is always good. Anyway, thanks for watching. See you in the next one.